Hello everyone, welcome to the 22nd online class of design of street structure. So in this session we are going to continue with the topic of design of the beams. So in the previous session we had seen regarding the design of the laterally unsupported beams. So we have already seen the design of two types of beam, okay, depending on the lateral stability, how the lateral stability is being given, okay. One is the laterally supported beams, that is the first case, and the design steps for that we have already seen. Then another one is the laterally unsupported, okay, unsupported beams. So for that, in the previous session I have told you what are the clauses you have to refer, which are the formulas you have to refer. So on based on that you have to design the beams. So in your syllabus only for a laterally supported beam we are going to design, okay, and the problems are will be related to only laterally supported, which means it will be supported at the ends. The beam, whatever might be the situation, it will be supported at the ends, whereas in laterally unsupported the beam will not be supported at the ends, okay, or at the midspan, okay. It might be at the midspan also, it might be supported. Here in laterally unsupported it might not be supported, okay. So here there will be a torsional buckling, lateral torsional buckling will be coming into picture, and you have to make sure that you have to consider this criteria in your design, okay. So this is the major things, okay, regarding the design of the beam, okay. Then as you all know that we are going to design for the value of MD, moment, okay, for the value of M, okay, that is for the value equal to MU. First step is to make sure that your MU equal to MD, that is factored bending moment will be equal to the design bending strength of the section, okay. After that you are going to find out the section, okay, then you are going to check it that section for with respect to the value of the V, that is for shear force, okay, V. So VU, okay, that is shear, factored shear should be less than the value of the VD, and here it should be MU should be less than the value of MD, okay. So these two conditions should be satisfied, okay. Then there are buckling checks, okay. The buckling checks will come into picture while designing the finding out the values of VD and MD, okay. In that itself it will be checked. Then there is one more criteria we have to check in every problem, that is regarding the deflection, okay. Deflection for a simply supported span by 300, okay, when there should not be any cracks which should form, okay. If it there is some cracks which is allowable, then you can make it the span by 360. For a cantilever it is spanned by 150. So those are the conditions which you have to remember. Otherwise you can directly refer the code books. Everything is there in your code book, step by step procedure for designing of the laterally supported as well as laterally unsupported beams are there in your code book, okay. So you have to refer those clauses, okay. The chapter 8 is for design of beams itself, okay, design of the beams. So this chapter every formulas, okay, 8.2 starts, okay, design of the laterally supported beams, okay, 8.2.2 and 8.2.3 starts with the laterally unsupported beam. So the formulas, everything are there in the code book itself, so no need to remember those formulas, just remember those page numbers and you can start your design, okay. Now in this session we are going to solve problems regarding the laterally supported beam. So in laterally supported beam, okay, design, so remember first thing what you need to find out is the value of the W. Value of the W is due to the load, okay, due to the loads which on the beams, the slab load will be coming, yeah, slab load will be coming, one thing. Then the floor finish of this slab will be coming, okay, floor finish. After that there will be a live load, okay, after that there will be a self weight of the beam whichever you are going to select, okay. If you are taking an I section, that self weight you also have to consider, that is the weight. For this weight you have to find out the factored weight, that is W, factored weight, okay. So this is the amount of factor load which will be coming onto the beam. For this value you have to find out the values of MU, that is factored bending moment, and VU, factored shear force. So for MU you are going to design the section, okay, and then for VU you are going to check it, okay. So this is the major criteria and major first steps, basic steps of designing of beams. Then to calculate the value of M as well as MD, okay, with then you have to find out the value of MD and VD. To find out the value of MD and VD you are going to refer the code books, okay, to find the formula. So this is the initial steps. Then the design steps are already taught to you in the previous sessions, okay, how to find out the value of MD, how to find out the value of VD, okay. So this is the starting initial step to calculate the value of W, okay, what is the load coming onto the beams, then you have to multiply with 1.5 to get the factor load. Once you get that factor load, you have to find out the value of mu, factored bending moment, and to find out the value of Vu, factored shear force. Once you get that, then you have to get the values of MD and VD. For finding out MD and VD, we have already seen the design steps. So MD basically depends on the value of VD and V itself. Okay. So there are two conditions, as I mentioned earlier and in the previous sessions. Okay. MD, basically, you have to find out for an assumption that V is less than 0.6 the VD value. One is that assumption, and in the second assumption, V is greater than 0.6 the VD. In one of these condition, it has to satisfy, and you have to find out. Then there are again two condition in this. Okay, one is for a plastic condition, another one is a plastic, and another one is a semi-compact. So for this condition, the beta value will change. Same here. Okay, for a plastic as well as semi-compact, the beta value and the formulas will be changing. So MD will have four formulas depending on the whether it's a plastic case, semi-plastic case, when V is less than 0.6 VD. Another case is when V is greater than 0.6 VD. For a plastic case, then semi-compact case, the MD value will be changing. Okay, then VD, main thing you have to remember is how to find out the value of AV. Okay, whether it's a rolled steel or whether it's a welded steel material. So if you take any section from your SP 6.1 1964, so if you take any section from this code book, the sections will be in a rolled steel case. Okay, so the you have to take H into TW. Okay, H is nothing but the total height of the section. Okay, so that value you have to find out with the AV equal to the total height of the section into TW. So that will get you the value of AV. So once you get that, you can find out the value of VD, then check whether your V is less than or equal to 0.6 VD or greater than 0.6 VD. After that, find out the formula for MD. Whichever formula is applicable depending on all these four conditions, you write down the value of MD. For that, find out the value of MD, then check these both conditions, MU, whether it is less than MD, and VU, less than VD. If it is safe, then go for the deflection check. If it is safe in that, then whatever your design is safe. So this is the brief idea of how we are going to design a beams. So that is a laterally supported beams. Now let me go to the today's session and solve the problems. Okay, so in many cases, remember that this sketch may or may not be given. You have to understand the statement here and draw this sketch. In this problem, they have given you the sketch, but in most of the cases in your exams, they won't give you this type of sketch. Okay, you have to assume this sketch and you have to draw with respect to the whatever the statement given in the question. So now don't think there is any sketch like this. Just read the question and try to figure out what is the things. So the internal dimension of the hull measures 8.5 meter into 14 meter. So take one side as 8.5 meter, another side as the 14 meter. Remember that. Okay. So the longer side, let it be in the horizontal, and the smaller side, let it be in the vertical case. Okay. In your exams also, do that way if they haven't given you the sketch. The concrete roof slab of thickness 120 mm. So thickness of the slab is given as 120. If you want to write it in mm, it is 1.2 mm because we required the calculation of weight with respect to mm. So 1.2 mm. Supported by 300 mm thick wall all around, which means that it is laterally supported. So it is supported by a 300 mm wall. So this is equal to 300 mm. Okay, this is equal to 300 mm. That's supported by all four sides. Okay, the slab rests on the I-beam. So the section they have already mentioned in the question itself. So in values, okay, you have to design an I section. Remember, in beam, you have to design an I section, because in the problem itself they have given that the slab rests on a I section. So I section you have to select. Okay, remember that they have only clearly given you the I section itself. And if not given, you can select any section, I section, channel section, angle section. But I prefer you that you select only I section for the beams. Remember that I section is good for beams. Rather than selecting the channel section or any other sections, select I section. Okay, because of the symmetricity and everything, it will be easy for you to solve the problem, and it is very easy for designing of an I section for the beams. Okay, equally spaced from 3.5 meter but spanning along the shorter side of the hull. So this beam is spanning along the shorter side, which means that the length whatever of the beam is, that is the span. So length is nothing but the span or the longitudinal axis. So the longitudinal axis is parallel to the whatever is the shorter side, that is 8.5 meters. So that is the meaning. Spanning along means the longitudinal axis or the span of the beam is parallel to the shorter side, which is here 8.5. If it is given that spanning along the longer side, then it will be like this, something like this. You should have drawn it, then another beam will be like this. So instead of, so that's why I'm telling you, understand the question properly. So they have clearly mentioned that spanning along the shorter side of the hall means the clear span will be equal to 8.5, because the longitudinal axis or the span of the beam is along the shorter side. If it is given in the longer side, then the span of the beam will be in the longer side. Okay, the clear span will be equal to the 14 meters. Okay, so here in the problem it is mentioned in the shorter side. If it is in the longer side, it will be like this horizontal one. Okay, so the distance between the each of it is 3.5 3.5. okay, then you have to find subtract the rest of the gap to find whatever the spacing if this diagram was not given. So in this case the diagram is given, so the end also the distance is 3.5 meter. Okay, that is the case. Design the beams if the live load is 3 kN/m². So the live load which is acting is 3 kN/m², and the floor finish, okay, finishing load, okay, that is nothing but the floor finish is 1 kN/m². Floor finish is nothing but the whatever you provide the marble stiles on the top of the slab, that is called as the floor finish. So that is equal to 1 kN/m². So these things are given. So in the problem they have given you the dimension of the room, then they have given the spacing between the beams, then they have given you the thickness of the slab as well as the wall thickness. So they have already told you that the section which you have to select is only I section, because the slab rests on I beams, they have told you. So the beam whatever you are going to design is an I beam. Okay, so then the spacing between the beams is 3.5 meter. Okay, that is also given. So the design of the beams for a live load of 3 kN/m², the live load is given and the floor finish is given. Also by the statement itself they have given you the span, that is the clear span of the beam also they have given you. Okay, so these things are given. So the first step, as I mentioned earlier, is to find out the value of the W, which is the total UDL acting on an I beam. Okay, estimation of total UDL, that is the total load. UDL is nothing but the total load which is acting on the beam. So that is what you have to find out first. So the working load W, kN/m². So per meter run, per meter, again per meter run. So for 1 meter run means that is perpendicular to the screen. For those 1 meter, you have to find out the value of the load, and that will be equal to the, then it will be considered that that load will be all over this slab itself. Okay, so per meter run you have to find out. So the self weight of this slab 0.12. Okay, 0.12 is the thickness into 1, that is per meter, into 3.5, that is the area of this region. Okay, 3.5 is the area of this region. You can directly take the thickness 0.12 into 3.5, nothing wrong in that, into 25 kN/m³. Okay, so we have seen in RCC we are just taking 0.12 into 3.5, say take same way 0.12 into 3.5, so into 25, okay, which will be in 10.5 kN/m. So that is the value. Okay, 3.5 nothing is the spacing, remember that 3.5 is the spacing, 0.12 is the thickness. Okay, this one you need not consider. Okay, this is just the 1 meter width which is perpendicular to the screen. Okay, so 0.12, that is in meter, and 3.5 is in meter, so into 25 kN/m³, meter get cancelled, so only 1 meter will be remaining. So 25 into 3.5 into 0.12, it is 10.5 kN/m. That is the self weight of the slab. Then finishing load of the beam, 1 into 3.5. 1 is again the width into 3.5, this dimension into the 1 kN/m². Okay, kN/m³. Okay, that is the floor finish. It should be kN/m³. Then it will be equal to 350 kN/m. Okay, 350 kN/m. Otherwise, you can directly take 3.5 into 1. No need to take this per meter run. If you remember the RCC concept, it is just we are multiplying 3.51 into the spacing into 1. Here also for live load, 3.5, the spacing into 3. That is what you are going to consider. So same way, floor finish 3.5 into 1. That is 1 is nothing but the floor finish. Okay, so floor finish equal to 350 kN/m. Then self weight of the beam, let us assume a value of 0.75 kN/m. So because they have given you the I section, let us assume some load, okay, of the I section, that is self weight. So in the problems, if you ask me how to get this value, take this value itself, okay. Stay first starting for your assumption, take this value of 0.75 kilonewton per meter. So whatever you are going to take the section, remember that I will tell you when the this chuck comes, okay. While taking the chuck, I will tell you, take this value itself, while selecting a section, convert this into kg per meter, because in steel tables, in SP6, okay, in steel table SP6.1 1964, in steel table the values of the loads are given in kg per meter, okay. So convert this value in kg per meter, which is equal to 76 point some values, okay, that is 76.86, I guess it is kg per meter, so I will show you that, okay, 76.453 kg per meter, okay. So here it is, conversion 76.453, so this value is here. Then you select a section which is closer to this weight also. So selecting a section closer to this weight, you select it in kg per meter, so that your assumption is almost safe, okay. Like that type of section you select it. Then the live load, so let us first assume this has the, assume the self weight of the I beam has something around this much, okay. Then the live load of the beam equal to 3.5 into 3, the spacing into the distance, which will be equal to 10.50. So if you multiply all these values, if you add all these loads, that is self weight of the slab plus floor finish plus self weight of the I beam plus live load, then the value of the W, that is the UDL, that is the total load acting on this beam, acting on this one on beam, it will be around 25.25 kilonewton per meter, which is equal to 25.25 newton per mm square. So this is the total amount of load. Now the factor load WU will be equal to per meter run W into 1.5 into W, 1.5 into 25.25, that is equal to 37.875 kilonewton per meter. So this is the amount of factor load, okay, this is the amount of factor load which is acting. For this you have to first find out the value of factored bending moment as well as the factored shear force, both things you have to find out, okay. So how to find out that? So this is nothing but a simply supported beam, and simply supported beam and UDL is acting, okay. For that you have to remember those formulas to find out the value of VU as well as MU, okay. So this is the first case. Now remember that if you do any mistakes in finding out the value of load, that is W itself, the whole problem will be wrong, and the design for will be done for a wrong loading condition, so all the marks will be lost. So remember that to find out this value of the W is very, very important, because the every other thing will be depending on this value of W itself. So remember, self weight of the slab will be equal to thickness into the spacing of the beams into 25, which will be equal to 10.50. No need to remember this per meter run. If you get confused, just take the value of thickness of the slab, okay, into the spacing between the beams, okay, into 25, which will be equal to 10.50 kilonewton per meter. Then floor finish equal to spacing of the beams into the floor finish load, okay, which will be equal to 3.5 into 1, 3.50. Then assume a self weight of something around 0.75 kilonewton meter. Then the live load of the beam will be again equal to spacing of the beam into the live load, which is acting, that is 10.50. Then add those weight to get the total weight. Then multiply with the factor load. Remember to multiply with the factor load also, okay. So this is the just a basic steps, okay. So this is just a basic step to calculate the value of the W, that is the load. Then you have to get the value of factor load W. So we have to design for the load of 37.875 kilonewton. Now as I mentioned earlier, in the compression member we are going to directly design for the load, that is PU, and in tension member we are going to design for the load TU, but whereas in our beams we are going to design it for the value of MU, that is the bending moment. And we are going to check it for the value of VU, that is for the shear force, what we are going to do, okay. So this is the basic initial steps, okay. Now let me find out the value of VU as well as MU, okay, for estimation of factored shear force and bending moment. So for this we require the effective span of the support to support of the beam, okay, that is LE we require. So how to find out this LE for a simply supported case is nothing but half of the thickness of the wall here and half of the thickness of the wall here, that is 300 divided by 2 and 300 divided by 2, okay. So if you have taken it the clear span in meters, then it is 8.5, okay, 8.5 you have taken it in meters here, 8.5 into 0.30, that is 300 converted to meter divided by 2 on the one side and 0.30 by divided by 2 on the other side. So the total effective span LE will be equal to 8.5 plus 2 times the 0.303 into 2, instead of writing 2 times 0.3 divided by 2. So 2 times into 0.302. So you can directly write it down 8.5 plus 0.3. Okay, that is the value of the L effective, okay, which is equal to 8.8 meter. Now, as I mentioned earlier, so and simply supported beam on which UDL will be acting like this, okay, UDL load will be acting on the beam like this. So this is your simply supported case, which is supported by a masonry wall, and the total load which is acting on that will be equal to 37.375, that is the total load, okay, total load, and the span will be equal to 8.8. So the shear force diagram for this type of loading case is nothing but like this way, okay. So shear force will be maximum at the support, okay, and this should be at the mid span, okay. The mid span, this shear force will be zero, and the bending moment diagram will be something like this. At the mid span, it will be maximum. So the values also you have to remember. So the support values will be WL/2, okay. The support reactions for this type of loading, the support reaction will be WL/2, and the shear force will be nothing but WLE/2. That is the value of the shear force itself, WL/2. Okay, that is the value of shear force itself. Then the value of the bending moment, which is maximum at the center, will be equal to WL²/8. So you have to remember this formula for a simply supported case, and the next case will be a cantilever case. Only for major these two things the problems will be there. So this formula, so you have to remember, and by now you should have known this values, okay, for a simply supported case, because it will be helpful in all the cases of your design. Remember that. So factor shear force at the end equal to support reactions itself, that is WL/2, okay. VU equal to W, that is factor. Here just W I have written, the basic concept. Now here it is W is nothing but 37.375, okay. It is 875, not 375, it is 875, okay. So 875 into 8.8, that is the effective length of the support to support of the beam, okay, divided by 2, it is 166.65, okay. That is the value of shear force, okay, factored shear force, which is coming on to this beam at the ends. Now factored maximum bending moment at the mid span, so the maximum bending moment will be at the mid span, okay, of the beam, which is equal to mu equal to W into LE²/8. So 37.875 into 8.8 whole square divided by 8, so which is equal to 366.63 kilonewton meter. So this is the two values, remember that, this is the two values for which we have to design. So now, as I mentioned earlier, we are going to design for mu, okay, design for mu and check for the value of shear force, okay. If it fails in shear also, you have to again design for the bending moment, then you have to go for the shear itself, then you have to check it for shear itself, remember that. Now what do you mean by designing for the mu value is nothing but, so if you remember your compression and tension member, whatever the load you are getting, that is TU or PU, for that values you are going to find out the area required, okay. Area required you are going to find out by assuming some stresses, then you will find out the area required. For this area required, you will select a section, okay, you will select a section from your steel table, okay, that is SP 6.1. you will select a steel section which is having a higher area than area required, like this way you are going to you have done till now. But now what will we do for this moment? So for this moment, remember that you are using those formula given in the code book, you are going to first find out the value of ZP required, okay. ZP required you are going to find out, that is nothing but the plastic section modulus. You have to find out this plastic section modulus, ZP required. Then you have to take a section, okay, section from your steel table SP 6.1, okay, which is having a higher value of ZP, which is having a higher value of ZB, which is greater than the ZP required. On this basis you are going to select the value of ZP required. So remember, for compression member and tension member, the area required you are going to calculate the first, but whereas in your beams, okay? Whereas in your beams, you have to find out the first the ZP required, that is met the plastic section modulus you are going to find out first. For those, you have to take a section, okay? You have to select a section which is having much more higher section modulus when compared to the plastic section modulus when compared to the value of mu. Remember that. That is what you are going to do in this steps, okay? So, in steel table, it will be clearly there. First, the properties, okay? The total depth of the section, okay? Total depth of the section, thickness of the web, thickness of the flange, everything will be given, okay? After that, they will be giving you the values of I, that is moment of inertia with respect to x, x, y, y. After that, they will be giving you the plastic section modulus also, ZP. Everything will be there on the code book. Based on ZP now, you have to select the sections, okay? And then write down all its property, that is H, TF, DW, then width of the flange, everything will be written down after finding out which is having a ZP greater than ZP required. After selecting that section, you are going to write down all the properties of that section, okay? So this is the basic step now, okay? That is what you meant by designing. So how you design with respect to MU is nothing but you are going to take the factored load, factored bending load will be directly equal to, that is maximum bending moment will be directly equal to the design strength, okay? Design strength of the section itself. We are going to directly assume it is equal to the design strength of the section. So MU will be directly equal to MD, what we are going to assume. And let us find out the value of ZP first. So let me show the steps now. Okay. Now selection of the section. So this is very important. Okay. The beam is laterally supported. So by now you got an idea that beam is laterally supported because it on the all four sides the beam is supported by the wall. Now as I mentioned earlier, let us assume that VU less than 0.6 VD. You can assume VU greater than 0.6 VD also. Nothing wrong in that. But the formulas will be too large and too many steps will be coming into picture. Okay, instead of that, let us assume that VU less than 0.6 VD. So for our easy calculation, let us assume this step, VU less than 0.6 VD. And the section has plastic or semi-compact, you can assume. Let us assume for this case has plastic section, okay. Let us assume the section has a plastic section and take the value of beta B equal to 1. So first, initially two assumptions you have to do. Remember, for getting the value of MD or MU, okay, which will be equating her together to find the value of ZP, to get the value of ZP, okay, which is nothing but ZP required, okay, that is the plastic section modulus which is required. To get the value of that, two things we have to assume. One, whether your value of VU is less than or greater than 0.6 VD. So for us, let us assume that VU is less than less than or equal to 0.6 VD, and let us assume that the section is the plastic section. So let us assume these two conditions first, okay? Then we have to check these conditions. Remember that, let us assume these two conditions first, then let us check whether these two conditions are satisfied or not. So that our assumption, whatever we have done, is proper or not. So the plastic section means beta B will be equal to 1, and VU less than 0.6 VD means this formula will be coming into picture. So as I mentioned earlier, let us equate this factor load, okay, factor bending moment will be equal to MD value, that is the design strength. So equal to this formula, when VU is less than 0.6 VD, it is equal to beta B into ZP into Fy divided by gamma M0. Now beta B will be equal to 1, MU equal to ZP into Fy divided by gamma M0. So we require the value of ZP itself, okay. So that is the section modulus, okay, plastic section modulus. So let us find out that ZP equal to ZP required. So ZP required equal to MU, that is the factor load. So how much amount to carry this factored bending moment, how much amount of the section modulus is required? Let us find out that. Then let us take a section which is having higher section modulus when compared to this ZP. Okay, MU into gamma M0 divided by Fy. 366.63 into 10 to the power of 6 into 1.1 divided by 250. So the ZP required equal to 116.13 into 116.13.172 into 10 to the power of 3 mm cube. So this is the amount of ZP required. Okay. So why I am writing into 10 to the power of 3 is because, so you have to take a section 1613.172 higher centimeter square. So remember that in steel table it will be given in centimeter cube. So in whatever the values you are getting is in mm cube. So that's why this 10 to the power of 3 is very important. Okay. So let us take a section which is having a 1613 centimeter cube section modulus greater than that. Okay, so a rolled I beam. So in problem itself, it is mentioned that you have to select an I section itself. So rolled I beam with ZP greater than ZP required is selected from the steel table. Okay, from the steel table you have to take that value. That is nothing but SP 6.1 1964. Okay, so now it is ISWB 450 79.4 kg per meter. So let us take this section. And one more thing, as I mentioned earlier, so you have taken 0.75, okay, kilonewton per meter has your assumed sulfate. So it is equal to something around 76.5453 kg per meter cube. So the actual weight of ISW is 79.4 kg per meter cube. So this is almost close enough. Okay, so nothing much variation will take place if it is 5 to 10 kg per meter cube difference. So assumed sulfate will also be okay. So make sure that this 5 to around 10 kg per meter cube, if you get the values, then it is well and good. Okay, then you see whatever you have assumed is well and good. Okay, the sulfate whatever you assumed is well and good. If you, there is a larger variation also, solve that problem, because okay, nothing, there few marks will be reduced, but it around 5 to 10 if there is variation, then it is well and good. Whatever you designed is correct, remember that. That is also one of the criteria while selecting a section, remember that. Okay, while selecting a section, you have to take in picture two things. One is ZP, and whatever the sulfate you have taken, that thing also you have to take in care. Okay, that is the weight, how much will be the weight of the section per meter, that is also keep in mind. Now it properties are ZP equal to 1760.59 into 10 to the power of 3. Just multiply the value, because 1760.59 will be in centimeter cube in the steel table. So just multiply with 10 to the power of 3, which will be in mm to the power of 3, greater than the ZP required. Okay, that is the ZP required is nothing but 1613.172 into 10 to the power of 3 mm cube. So that's why you are selecting a section. And remember that while selecting a section, take as much as higher values, okay, nearly 150 or 200 mm cube more than the value which is required, okay, to be safer in the all the checks which is coming. Okay, to be safer in the all the checks which is coming, take the value of ZP greater than 150 or 200 mm cube. Okay, greater than that value you have to take it. Okay, so that whatever the checks which you are going to do in the next, that the member should be safe in, or the section should be safe in. Now the properties of this section from the steel table itself, write it down. Okay, B suffix F, that is the thickness of the flange, sorry, width of the flange B suffix F is 200 mm, thickness of the flange 15.4 mm, TW, thickness of the web 9.4 mm, and write down the properties of I itself, I of the section. Okay, I of this section also write it down. Okay, which I have written it in the next slide when I is used, and write down the value of root radius also. This is also required. Write down the values while writing down these properties itself. Okay, now area is not required, but whereas if you remember in the case of the compression moment tension paper, you have to take the area consideration. Now area is not required, no need to write down anything regarding the area. Area is nowhere used in the formulas. If you seen, remember the formulas whatever I taught you in the previous session. Now the value of B, okay, the B is nothing but B suffix S by 2, that is nothing but flange width divided by 2. Why you required this B is to find out the condition whether it is in plastic section or not. So for that you have to refer this table number 2. Limiting width to thickness ratio. Now you have to check for a rolled steel section. So as I mentioned earlier, if you take any section from your steel table, it will be a rolled steel section. Now you have to check that B by TF. So B is nothing but the flange width, okay, B suffix F divided by 2. It should be less than 0.9 for xi. Xi is nothing but square root of 1 by half is there. So square root of 250 divided by Fi. So that is the value. Okay, it should be less than that. Then for a web of an I, okay, if generally the R1 is positive, as I mentioned earlier, write down the value of R1 also. If it is positive, then D by TW should be less than 84 times xi plus 1 plus R1, but it should also be less than 42 times the rise xi. So these two conditions are satisfied, then the section is in plastic case. Then whatever you are assumed here, beta B will be equal to 1, that will be satisfied. So B will be equal to B suffix X divided by 2. So B of this section is 200 divided by 2, it is 100 mm. Then depth of the width, depth of the web is also required. Depth equal to d minus 2 times the thickness of the flange, whatever I told you in the previous session, plus r1 will be coming into picture, that is the root radius. So if you see in a practical case, the I section will be something around like this, okay, and when the webs are connected to the flange, it will be curved here, okay. The curvedness also you have to take into consideration, you have to reduce that curvedness also, okay, then it will be a straight section like this. So this will be the root radius, whatever the curvedness that is provided, that is the root radius. So you have to subtract that value also, that's why this r1 will be coming into picture, that is the root radius. So instead of just writing the total depth minus 2 times the thickness of the flange, okay, thickness of the flange, we are minusing with 2 times the root radius also to get the highest accurate value of the d, that is the web height. So this will be your web height from here, not from the base of the flange itself, from the here. Minusing the root radius also is very important. Again, it will be something like this. Then there will be a flange like this, okay. So in practical cases, this will be consideration. So let us take that itself. So the d value will be in between this, okay. The total depth will be from here to here, and this will be the root radius, okay. The total depth d, or h you can say, h it is given in your steel table. So h or d, the total depth will be minus by 2 times the thickness of the flange, then the minus 2 times the root radius to get the value of small d, that is the height of the flange, okay. So d minus 2 into tf plus r1, which is equal to 450 minus 2 into 15.4, that is the thickness of the flange, and root radius r1 is 14. That's why I told you to write down this r1 also, okay, and write down the value of I from the steel table when you are writing down these properties, which will be equal to 391.2 mm. Then the xi value, okay, xi value is square root of 250 divided by fi, 250 divided by fi. So the yield strength of any steel rolled steel section will be equal to 250. It might be for a flange, it might be for a web, totally for an rolled steel section, if you have taken anything from your Indian standard code book, that will be equal to 250, which will be equal to 1. So b by tf, which is 100 by 15.4, which will be equal to 6.494, and it is less than 9.4 xi. So xi is 1, it is less than 9.4 from table 2 of IS 800 2007. Then another condition what you have to check is d by tw, 391.2 divided by 9.4, so 41.617. again it is less than 84 times xi plus 1 plus r1, but not more than 42 over xi also. So in this case, both the cases it is safe now, okay, it is less than these two values, okay. So it is less than this value as well as this condition. So it is now the whatever the section you have chosen is of class 1, that is of plastic section. The class of section is in class 1 and it is of plastic section, okay. So therefore what you have assumed here, beta b equal to 1 is correct, okay. One thing what you have assumed is correct. Then as I mentioned earlier, the self weight of the I beam assumed is equal to 0.75, and which is equal to 76.453 kg per meter cube. Actual weight of ISWB given in the steel table itself is 79.4 kg per meter. So assumed self weight, which is nearly equal to 5, extra weight will be there, but it is okay if you take 5 to 10 variation, it is okay. So assumed self weight is also correct, okay. Then no need to change if there is less variation of 5 to 10 kg per meter, no need to again change the weights. If once you change the weight, whole design will be changing, so remember that. So no need to do that thing. So let make sure that it is between 5 to 10. So the two checks are now done. Now to find out the value of mu, first thing you have to do is, now where you have to check this value also, whether your vu is less than 0.6 vd or not. Then let us see how to find out the value of md now, okay. Now we haven't found out the strength of the section, okay. Strength of the section vd also we have not found out, md also not found out, okay. Now just that we have selected one section and found out that the plastic condition is satisfied and this section is in plastic state, as well as the load whatever we have taken is safe. That two things we have just now got to know. Now the next step is to find out the shear strength. So vd will be equal to av into fiw divided by gamma m naught into root 3, okay. This is there in your clause 8.4 of a steel table, okay, clause 8.4. So vd equal to av is nothing but d into tw for a rolled steel section. Av equal to d into tw for a rolled steel section. So this is for a rolled steel section, okay, rolled steel section, okay, 450 into 9.4 FYW. As I mentioned earlier, for a web or a flange, for a normal rolled steel section, the value of the yield strength will be equal to 250. So gamma m naught will be equal to 1.1 divided by root 3, which is equal to 555.04 kilonewton. So this is the value of Vd. So Vu equal to 166.65 kilonewton, and it is less than 0.6 Vd, whatever you assume. So let us see that. 0.6 into 555.04, which is equal to 333. So 333.03 kilonewton, hence it is safe, hence it is okay. So whatever we have assumed is also correct. The value of the what we have assumed, this one thing what we have assumed, Vu is less than 0.6 Vd we have assumed and started the problem, okay, started the design, and we have assumed the plastic state. Now both the condition has been satisfied, okay. Then for these two condition, the value of the MD, the formula to calculate the value of MD is nothing but beta B into ZP into FI into gamma M naught. If any one of this condition is not satisfied, no need to worry, just change this formula. If this condition is satisfied, not satisfied, Vu is not less than 0.6 Vd, your value of the MD, the design bending strength, will be equal to MdV. That is the only change. If this is not in plastic state, if it is in semi-compact state, then you have to find out the value of beta B, that is nothing but Ze divided by Zp, okay. So those types of problems also we are going to solve when this is not satisfied in the next session, okay. Now in this session, let us solve the same conditions, okay. Now check for the moment capacity. Remember that to check for the moment capacity, you have to also need to check this criteria also, whether there is any web buckling or not, that is D by Tw. So D by Tw is nothing but the depth and the thickness of the web. So this is for a web buckling. So if there is no web buckling, then it is good. So 41.67, which is less than 67 psi, which is less than 67. So hence there is no web buckling. So you can use this formula of MD equal to beta B into ZP into FI into gamma M naught. Now beta B, plastic section 1, ZP of the I section, which you have taken from the steel table, 1760.59 into 10 to the power of 3. Now this is the section, the section whatever you have chosen, how much is the strength of this section in moment. So what is the moment carrying capacity of the section, that is what you are going to find out, that is MD, okay. In that's why the ZP of the section from the steel table you have to write it down, okay, SP 6.1 into FI 250 divided by gamma M naught 1.1 and divided by 10 to the power of 6. Why? Because so that your answer will be directly in kilonewton per meter cube, okay. So 400.134 kilonewton per meter cube, which is greater than the value of mu, okay, that is 366.63 kilonewton per meter, hence okay. So now the two conditions are already satisfied. One is that Vu is less than Vd, so safe in shear. Then mu is less than the MD, that is for bending also it is safe. So whatever you have taken the section is safe in both the condition, hence the design is okay. Now the last condition what you needed to check is for the deflection. So for a deflection, so for a simply supported beam, okay, so for a simply supported beam, and UDL is acting on the beam, okay, and UDL is acting on the beam, that is nothing but equal to 25.25 newton per mm, that much amount of UDL is acting, the deflection will be something like this, okay. So you have to find out the mid-span deflection, okay, deflection, that is delta. Again you have to remember this formula, delta is nothing but 5 by 384. So these formulas are not there in your current book, you have to remember 5 by 384 WL to the power of 4, okay, divided by EI. So this is the formula how to calculate the value of delta. So remember in steel, if the value of E, Young's modulus of steel, is not given, it is directly 2 into 10 to the power of 5 newton per mm square. So no need to scratch your head to get the value of E. It is just 2 into 10 to the power of 5 newton per mm square. Or you can take 2.1 into 10 to the power of 5 newton per mm square also, it is correct. Okay, that is the value of E. I value, as I mentioned earlier, I value you have to get it from your steel table for the section, SP 6.1. That's why I have to mention in the previous slide itself, just write down the value of I also, it is required. Okay, so the maximum deflection delta will be equal to 5 into WL to the power of 4 divided by 384 EI, 5 into 25.25, that is the load, total working load, okay, which is coming onto the beam, into 8800 to the power of 4, that is the L effective, okay, L effective, remember that, L effective, that is the support to support of the section, okay. Now here remember that you have to take the working load, W, remember that. So divided by 384, not 37 fan, total factor load you can, you need not need to multiply with, you have to multiply with the working load, remember that. If you take the factor load, then this reflection will be more higher than the safe deflection. Here it is for the working load we have to take, not for the factor load. Divided by 384, E value 2 into 10 to the power of 5, okay, everything is substituted in mm, Newton, mm, everything has been substituted, Newton and mm. So that's why the E value is in Newton per mm square is 2 into 10 to the power of 5. Okay, the conversion is also important. If they give you 2 megapascal, also you have to convert this here same way, and it will be equal to 2 into 10 to the power of 5 Newton per mm square. So remember in this way itself, okay, into the I value of this section, okay, IES, WB section, whatever you assume, okay, for that section, okay, IS, WB, for that section, what will be the value of I? So, 35, so it is 35,057, okay, 35,057.6 into 10 to the power of 4, so the deflection value is 28.12 mm. Now, how to find out the permissible deflection? So, permissible deflection is given in your table 6 of IS 800-2007. So, I told you to remember for only one case, when there is no cracking, the deflection will be, should be less than effective span by 300, that is 8800, that is the effective span, divided by 300 is 29.33. So, the permissible deflection, total deflection which is on the coming on the beam is 28.12. But the permissible deflection is 29.3, hence it is okay. Remember here you have to take the working load. If you take this total factor load, then this condition won't be satisfied, then you have to do it again. So remember the deflection criteria is for service load and working load, okay, not for the factored load, okay. Don't do that mistakes in your exam, okay. Hence it is safe. So the design of this problem is ended here. So remember, first thing what you have to do is correctly assume the weight. After assuming the weight, find out the factored, okay, and multiply with the factored load and get the value of factored load. Then find out the value of mu, vu. After that, start designing by assuming the values, okay. Assume that vu is less than 0.6 vd or greater than 0.6 vd, nothing wrong in that. Then assume a section, whether it's in plastic or in semi-compact, let us assume for these two conditions itself, okay. For all problems, let us start with these two conditions because the formulas will be easy. Then find out the value of Zp required by equating the value of mu equal to md. That is the next step. Then select a section, okay. Then select a section. Here it is I section is clearly given. So select a section having Zp greater than Zp required. Select the section. Then write down its property. Write down its properties, then check whether its section is plastic or not with respect to table number 2. After checking that, check the load whichever you assumed and whatever you have taken from the section is almost equal or not. After that, check for this condition VU less than 0.6 VD by finding out the value of VD according to the clause 8.4. After checking that, if it is safe, then find out the value of MD using the formula given in the code book with respect to these conditions. Okay, plastic or semi-compact or V is less than 0.6 VD or not. After finding out the value of MD and VD, check whether it is greater than the factored VU as well as the MVU. Okay, if it is safe, then lastly check for the deflection, okay, for the service load. If it is safe, then your design is done and the section what you have taken is good, okay, while taking care of the loads which is coming onto that section. This is where the design ends. This is for a laterally supported beam. Now let us solve one more problem. Now for the same problem, okay, same problem, okay, same, solve the above problem 8.2, that is this problem itself, when the depth of the I beam is restricted to 370. So the I beam depth, the total depth of an I beam, okay, from flange end to the other flange end, that is the value of edge, is restricted to 370 mm, okay. What we have to do in this situation if it is the depth is restricted, okay? So in this situation we have to plate extra plates, okay. This is the flange now, and over it we are going to place an extra plates like this, okay. This is the web, okay. So this is the flange, over it we are going to place the extra plates, okay. From total depth will be from here to here, the value of h. Over this we are going to place the extra plates so that the loads which are coming onto it will be safely carried, okay. So let us solve this problem. What is the difference if the depth of the I section is restricted? So VU, you have already found out the load will be the same, factor load will be the same because the same loading conditions are there, 37.75 kilonewton per meter. So this is the loading cases will be the same. For that, find out the value of VU, MU. Then equate MU equal to MD. I am not doing that steps again. And for the plastic case and VU less than 0.6 dVd, you'll get the value of ZP required, which is equal to 1613.72 into 10 to the power of 3. Now take a section, and that depth of the section should not be greater than 350. So the section selected is ISHB 350 itself. So the maximum depth is 350 itself. Let us take the section equal to 350 itself. So ISHB 350 at the rate 67.4 kg per meter cube. So you have assumed the 76.85 or 35 kg per meter cube is the load. So it is less than 10 kg per meter cube, hence it is okay. So this condition is also satisfied, and its following properties are, so ZP is 1213, which is less than 10, okay, it is fine. Now it is fine because here the depth is restricted. So whatever might be the case, you cannot take the value greater than ZP required, okay. So ZP is this much. B suffix F, that is the flange width, is 250 mm, thickness of the flange is 11.6 mm, thickness of the web is 8.3 mm, R1, the root radius is 14.93, I-axis is 19,159.7 into 10 to the power of 4 mm. So this is what I have told you to write down in the previous problem. So write all this data at one place so that it will be easy for your calculation. Now ZB of ISHB, that is high strength beam, is less than the ZP required. Now if you remember, in the last problem it is W we have taken, now in this problem HB we have taken, okay, nothing wrong. You can assume HB section also, HB section has higher load carrying capacity than WB section, remember that, that is the only difference, okay, because your depth is restricted, we are going for the higher section, that is HB section. Thus the section should be strengthened with additional plates to provide the ZP required. So we have to make sure that we are providing extra plates on top of the flange so that the ZP required will be ZP will be greater than ZB required of the beam. To maintain the stiffness of the built up I section with steel plates, the deflection of this beam should be less than the governed by the table number 6 of IS 800-2007. As per code, the maximum deflection is effective span by 300. So 8800 is the span which you have seen in the last previous case itself, 8800, okay, divided, which will be equal to 29.33. actual deflection equal to 5 into WL to the power of 4 divided by 384 EA, which should be less than maximum deflection 29.33 mm. So equating that now, okay, I is taken out, here I is replaced with delta actual. So in this is interchange. So what is the I required, okay, moment of inertia required, we are going to find 5 into WL for 25.25 into 8800 to the power of 4 divided by 384 into 2 into 10 to the power of 5 into actual deflection, okay, 29.33, which will be equal to this much value of I in mm to the power of 4. Now adopt a steel plate of 8 mm thickness on the both side, like this, 8 mm thickness on the both side, okay, and K be its width as shown. So let this width be K, okay, on the top of the flange we are going to use it, so let that width be equal to K, okay. If it is equal to the flange width, let us find it. If not, it is greater, then it is also fine. So okay, that is what you are going to do. So let K be the width as shown in the figure 5A.6. So this is the sketch, okay, built up I section, okay, below. So it should be 5A.14, okay, below, and it is designed for I value of this much mm to the power of 4. So I of a built up section, so I of this built up section equal to IX6 of ISHB, so IXS of IHSB plus IXS of the plate. So this plate IX6 you have to find out. Now here the K is unknown, okay, the total I which is required we have already found out with respect to the deflection criteria. With respect to deflection criteria, what is the I required we have found out. Now we have to find out what is the flange width, okay, that is K, or sorry, plate width, that is K we needed to find out, okay. So this I of the built up section which we have found out with respect to the deflection will be equal to the IXX of the ISHB, which is given, we will get it from the steel table, plus K into, that is BD cube, okay, BD cube. Now here the BD cube is taken with respect to full, so full rectangular section is taken like this, okay, full K into 350, okay, that is the full section, okay, 350 plus 2 into 8 to the power of 3. Okay, 2 into 8 to the power of 3 divided by 12. So k is this, and 2 350, that is full. Okay, full width plus 2 times the 8 into 10, that is this thickness you have to add, right? So this whole thing we are going to consider now, okay, for the calculation. That is the 350 plus 2 into 8 whole to the power of 3, that is the depth, divided by 12, that is BD cube by 12, okay, minus, now the minus you have to do the rest of the places, that is k into 350 cube, this is not required, right? K into 350 cube by 12, we are going to minus it. So solving the above equation by interchanging, by subtracting this, and you will get it in the form of an equation. So solving that, okay, you will get the value of k. Using your calculus, solve that, you will get the value of k as 340.364 mm. So the value of k is 340.364 mm. So add up two plates of size 350 into 8 mm on the top and the bottom of the beam. So top and the bottom, let us take the value as 350. 340 you got, round it up to higher great number. If you get around 370 also, take it as 400 mm itself, okay? So that it should be a proper values, okay? 350, if you get around 325 also, take it as 350 mm plates itself, remember that. Add up two plates of size 350 into 8 mm on the top and the bottom of the beam. So actual I provided will be equal to I of the ISHB section plus the values 350 into 350 plus. So here into 2 into 8, 10 to the power of 350. Now k, instead of k you are substituting that value, divided by 12 minus 350 into 350 cube. Instead of k we are substituting, because we have assumed the value of k, right? So 350 cube divided by 12, we will get it around 37, something this much value, mm to the power of 4, which is greater than I required, okay, equal to 3 something, which is okay. So I required is 3361 this much. So I, whatever you got is this much, so it is okay. Now let us check for shear. So checking for shear now, VU less than, VU equal to 0.665, okay, so it is less than 0.6 VD, okay, VD is missing here, 0.6 VD, so VD equal to 0.6 into 381.183, which is equal to 228.71, okay. Now 381, you have got it here, VD equal to AV into FIW into gamma m naught into root 3 DW into D into TW, that is for I section itself you have to take, D is 350 and TW is 8.3 of the I section, whatever you have the formulas, you have written it here, okay, the section, okay, TW is 8.3 and 350 is the value of total depth of the I section, divided by gamma m naught, okay, 1.1 divided by root 3. So the value of VD is 381.183, and the value of VD with respect to 0.6 times this is equal to 228.71. So VU is 165.1 kilonewton. So this value is safe, hence the section is adequate, whatever the section we have selected is adequate, okay, in both the conditions. So VD is greater than VU, so safe. And the assumption what you have taken, VU should be less than 0.6 the VD, this also condition is satisfied. So hence the section whatever you have selected is adequate. Now let us check for the moment capacity, okay, D by TW. First thing you have to check is, as I mentioned earlier in the previous problem also, you have to check for this D by TW, which is equal to 350 divided by 8.3, 42.17, which is less than 67 xi. Xi is nothing but square root, so no need to do it once, you just write it down, 250 divided by Fi, okay, Fy, so 250 divided by Fi, so F 250 divided by square root of 250 divided by 250 itself, okay, 250 itself, which is equal to 1, that is the value of xi, so 67, it is less. Now MD value equal to beta b into Zp into Fi divided by gamma m naught, so 1 into 2215.93, that is the value of Zp, okay, into 10 to the power of 3 into 250 divided by 1.1 into 1 by 10 to the power of 6, which is equal to 503.62 meter, which is greater than mu, 366.63 kilonewton, which is okay. Hence whatever the section you have chosen is safe. Now what is the Zp of the built up section if you consider, okay, so built up section Zp is what? So this is the Zp of the I section only, okay, if you see it here, okay, the I section Zp is, okay, sorry, you have to find out, sorry, you have to find out this value of Zp first. So Zp value you have to find out of the built up section. So first step is this, Okay, first step you have to find out the value of ZP. ZP of the build-up section equal to ZP of the ISHP, which is this much, which you have taken from the steel table SP6.1, 1964. So ZP of the plates is nothing but plate is a rectangular plate, so that is BD square by 6. So totally you have to take it. So 350 from the total I section, because it is top and bottom it is provided. So of the total I section you have to take the section. Okay, total I section you have to take it. And you have to consider the plates also of the above the that. Okay, so it is B 350 full. Okay, into 350 is this B. Okay, 350 is this, then the full 350 plus 2 into 8 to the power of whole square, that is B D square. Okay, 350 plus 2 times 18, okay, that is 16. 350 plus 16 whole square divided by the 4 minus 350 into 350, that is this depth you have to minus, right? 350 into 350 whole square divided by 4, that is equal to this much value of ZP, that is substituted here to find out the value of MD. So MD, now don't directly substitute the value of the I section itself, substitute the value of the ZP of the built up section, because you are considering a built up section and you have to find out the total built up section bending strength. So the total built up section bending strength equal to MD equal to 503.62 kilonewton per meter, which is greater than the MU value, which is 366 kilonewton per meter. Hence it is safe. Okay, now check for the deflection. For a working load 25.25 kilonewton, the values 5 into W into L to the power of 4, 5 into 25.25 into 8,800, 384 E value, that is Young's modulus of steel, 2 into 10 to the power of 5, I value of the total built up section. Remember that I value of the total built up section, which you have calculated here, and this is the value, okay, I of the I provided. So that value you have to use it. So you'll get it as 26.57. Okay, that deflection value you have already seen, span by 300, which you have checked in the this problem in the steps itself. Okay, to find out the value of I, we have used that step, span by 300. So it will be around 29.33 mm. So the deflection criteria also safe. Permissible deflection criteria is also safe. Hence this beam is safe in the all three cases, moment, shear and the deflection. Remember that in this type of problems you have to do one more step, that is the curtailment of the flange plates. So if the flange plate need not needed to be provided for the full length, so you can curtail it at the ends. So let us see how to curtail it. Okay, so the other steps will be easy, only this step will be extra. The flange plate can be curtailed in the support of the beam, since the bending moment, which is maximum at the mid span, reduces to zero and parabolic at the support. So if you see for a simply supported case, okay, if you see for a simply supported case with an UDL acting on it, the bending moment will be parabolic variation, and at the supports, at the support, if I going to consider, okay, let me draw it again. So for the support it will be zero. Okay, let me draw it again, let me show it neatly. Okay, so this is your simply supported beam, okay, with UDL acting on it. Okay, for this the bending moment diagram, okay, so for this the bending moment diagram will be like this way. Okay, maximum at the center and zero at the support. So at this support you need not need to plate this plates, extra plate what you are seeing on the above the flanges, no need to do that. So that is the curtailment. So theoretical cutoff point of an analytical method or any method, geometrical method, can be computed as follows. So moment capacity of ISHB 350 equal to MP into ZP, sigma y into ZP, that is the stress, yield stress, 250 into ZP, which is the I section. You have to write it down, you will get it from the steel table. 1213.53 into 10 to the power of 3, this much is your MP, okay, that is 303.3825 kilonewton. Now moment about the section of XX in the beam of each support. So if you take the XX at this support here, XX, you are going to take it now. Now let us find out the what is the moment at this section at XX here, VU into X. So VU into X minus WU into X square divided by 2. So W will be the load, that is 37.85. Now this distance let me take it as X, okay, here at the support, near the support I am going to take the value as X. Now I have to find out this X, where the curtailment length can be reduced at the, from the support. So VU, V into X, that is the one case, minus WL X square divided by 2. So VU is 166.65. That is the factored load, okay, into X minus 37.875 into X square divided by 2 kilonewton per meter. Now equating to the value of equating to the value of MP. Okay, equating the MX to the MP. So you can find out the value for equilibrium MP equal to MXX. Okay, that is the condition. Then you will get it in this form. Then rearrange it to get a quadratic equation. So using your calculator itself, you can directly find out the value. That is two values you will get it because it's a quadratic equation. One is 6.2275 meter. Another one is 2.5725 meter. So consider x equal to 2.575 meter, the smallest one, 2.5 meter for each ends of the support. This x one. So the value of x is 2.5 meter. This value here, both side it is 2.5 meter. So here in 2.5 meter you can curtail it. Okay, let the curtail flange plate be extended from another 300 meter from the both ends. So 300 meter is your support, that is the masonry wall itself. So you have to reduce that. So the actual curtailment length of the flange plate is 2.5 minus 0.3, that is 2.2 mm. So this is from the center to center of the support. But remember that there is a masonry wall. So in masonry walls you cannot provide those plates. So you can reduce that also. So the actual curtailment will be 2.2 mm. So this is how you do the curtailment of the flanges at the ends. So you have to find out what is that distance. That's it. What is that x distance, and find out equating MP equal to MXS. So this is an easy step. Okay, if there is a time, do the design and do all the checks and leave some spaces, then solve other problems. And if there is time, do this curtailment of the flange in the exams. Okay, so this is the one more extra step in this type of problem when there is a plate added to it, because at the ends there is no bending moment. You need not need to provide the plates. Now for how much is the length, we need not need to provide this flange plate. You have to find out by equating MP equal to MXX. So MXX, if you want to equate, what is the value of X? What is that length you are going to make sure that there is no the plates required, that is the curtailment of the flange. So here the design problem ends in this case. Okay, this is where the design problem ends. Now let us solve one last problem in this session. Now this is for a cantilever problem. Okay, now till now we have solved two problems regarding the simply supported case. Now this is for a cantilever case. Okay, all the steps whatever I taught you in the simply supported case is similar in the cantilever case. Only thing, the formula which are changing, only the formulas will be changing. So let us see that. Now a cantilever beam of span 5 meter is to be supported by a dead load of 20 kilonewton. So dead load is directly given and the live load is 10 kilonewton per meter. So no need to assume now the other cases. Okay, whatever they have given, if they have given floor finish, take those values. Okay, if they have given directly the dead load, no need to again assume the weight of the I section or something like that. Don't need to do any of these conditions. Remember that only directly go for the steps itself. Okay, live load of 10 kilonewton per meter. Assume a bearing length of 100 mm. Design a cantilever beam. Now bearing length is given, that is nothing but the B1. Okay, B1 is given. So if you remember, this B1 will coming into picture only when there is a web buckling case. That is for the web crippling and web buckling case. So you require that B1. If you remember those sketches which I mentioned in the previous session, okay? In the previous session, I have told you regarding the web crippling and web buckling. In this situation, to calculate the values of F, that is the force, you require this B1 value, okay? That is given here. So you have to check it for the web buckling case also in this problem. Remember that if and only if they have given you the bearing length, then you have to check it for the web buckling case also. Note, okay, this design is for laterally supported. So in exam, if they haven't mentioned you whether it is a laterally supported or not, you directly take it as laterally supported, because in VTO syllabus, it is the problems you are going to solve it is only for the laterally supported. No numerical problems are there for a laterally unsupported case. So first thing, calculate the factored bending moment and shear force. So first, factored dead load 1.5 into 20, then factored live load 1.5 into 10, 30 plus 15. Total UDL, total load which is acting, MU equal to 45 kilonewton per meter. N should be capital, okay? And MU, okay? MU for a cantilever case, okay? MU for a cantilever case is WUL square by 2, okay? And VU is WU into L. So hopefully you remember those diagrams. No need to do these diagrams and all, okay? How the variation of shear force will be taking place. No need to do those diagrams and everything. This is the variation of the shear force at the support. It is the support. It is maximum at the ends. It is zero. This is the shear force. Then the bending moment also, you have to draw it. Okay. So the bending moment is something like this. Okay. This is the bending moment, parabolic. Okay. Parabolic bending moment. So the maximum value of the bending moment is WU L square by 2. Okay. And shear force maximum will be equal to WU into L. So the load will be WU, and this support, the value is equal to support reaction WU into L. So MU equal to WL square by 245 is the total UDL L. Now there is no mentioning of the support to support conditions. So let us take that L directly as your effective length. Okay, in this case, if they have not given you the end resistance like masonry wall and anything, directly take the L effective as the value of L. So 5 square divided by 2, 562.5 kilonewton per meter is the value of MU. VU will be equal to W into L, 45 into 5, 225. Now let us start the design. Plastic modulus required. So we are equating now, I am not retaining all the steps. MD will be equal to MU, we are equating, and we are assuming that V is VU is less than the value. VU is less than the value of 0.6 the VD, we are assuming that, and we are assuming that this is a common step and you have to write it down only in this problem. I am not writing it down, okay. So in the problems, in exams, you have to write down these steps, okay. This carries marks. So 0.6 times the VD, and plastic section you are going to assume. Once you assume it is as a plastic section, beta B will be equal to 1, and the value of MD will be equal to ZP into FI into gamma M0. By rearranging, I found out the ZP equal to MU into gamma M0 divided by FI. So I have just skipped few steps here, okay, and I am directly finding out what is the ZP required. So the ZP required equal to 562.5, that is the MU value, into 10 to the power of 6 for the conversion, okay, conversion of meter to mm, 10 to the power of 6 into gamma m naught value 1.1 divided by 250, that is 2475 into 10 to the power of 3 mm cubed. So this is the value of ZP required. Now from the steel table, let us take a trial section. We are taking a trial section of ISMB medium, okay, 515 into weight of 1.037 kilonewton per meter. So ZP required is 2701.98 into 10 to the power of 3, okay. Okay, this is the ZP of the trial section, and the required is 2475 into 10 to the power of 3. So ZP required is greater than ZP is greater than ZP required. So hence the section is same. Now write down the value of ZE also, okay. In problems, make it a habit of writing down the ZP also, which is you will get this all these values from the steel table itself. Write down all these values, okay. 6.1 1964, you will get all these values from the steel table itself. So ZE value equal to 2359.8, and don't get confused with respect to ZP and ZE value. Both the values will be there in your steel table itself, and don't take any ZE value greater than ZP value in your tables, and don't make those mistakes, okay. See properly which is the ZP value, and with respect to that itself you have to select the section, okay. ZE value and ZP value will be together in the steel table, remember that. And width of the flange is 190, thickness of the flange is 19.3, thickness of the web is 11.2. IZZ is that much value, 64,900 into 10 to the power of 4 mm to the power of 4, and R1 value 18 mm, and R minimum is 37.3 mm, and A value is 132.4 into 10 to the power of 4 mm. So why R minimum is greater than R1 is because this is nothing but the root radius. Remember that this is the root radius. So R minimum is nothing but greater value of RXX to RYY, which is the least value. I have written it as R minimum. So R here is different, and R1 is totally different. R1 and R2 are the root radius. You required only R1. Remember that. R minimum is least of the RXX and RYY. That is the two different cases itself. Remember that. So whatever the value of less of RXX and RYY, or RZZ and RYY, whatever the least value, write it as R minimum equal to 37.3 mm. So A value is 132.4 into 10 to the power of 4 mm square. Now the section classification from table 2, you have to think whether it is a plastic section or not. B equal to width of the flange divided by 2, 190 divided by 2, 95 mm, and D value 550 minus 2 times the thickness of the flange into plus the root radius. So it is 475.4 mm. Now B by TF, 95 divided by 19.3, 4.933, which is less than 9.4 into xi, xi value square root of 250 divided by 250, which is equal to 1. Okay, so it is less than 9.4 when hence it is safe. Then d by tw, 475.4 divided by 11.2, 42.45, which is less than 84 mm. So whatever the section you have assumed is a plastic section, then it is good. So beta b value will be equal to 1. This is the condition now. Now let us check for the shear. So D by TW, 42.45, which is less than 60 for xi, then this condition is also satisfied. Now Vd equal to Vp divided by gamma m naught, Vp equal to Av into Fi divided by root 3 into gamma m naught. You can just directly write down this value. Okay, directly write down Vd equal to H into Tw, that is the total height. You can write it as capital D also, nothing wrong. H into Tw into Fi W divided by root 3 into gamma m naught. So An equal to H into Tw for major axis bending for a hot rolled steel, as I mentioned earlier, clause 8.1.1. So you have seen in both two problems which I solved earlier. Okay, Vd equal to 550 into 9.2 into 250 divided by root 3 divided by 1.1 divided by 10 to the power of 3, because directly I will get the value in kilonewton per meter, Vd value 8.803 kilonewton. So 0.6 Vd, 0.6 into 8.803 kilonewton, 485 kilonewton. So Vu is 225 and 0.6 Vd is 485 kilonewton. Hence the second assumption is also correct. Clause 8.2.3, when Vu less than 0.6 Vd, Md is calculated in step 5. So Md formula is beta B into Zp into Fi into gamma m naught. Okay, beta B is 1 for a plastic section. Okay, plastic section beta B is 1. Okay, plastic and a compact section beta B is 1, not for a semi-compact, it is for a compact section. Okay, so this, there is a slight mistake here. For plastic and a compact section beta B equal to 1. So finding out that beta B equal to 1, okay, 1 into Zp value, which is you are getting from the code book itself, 2711.98 into 10 to the power of 3 into 250 divided by gamma m naught 1.1 into 10 to the power of 6, you will get it as 616 kilonewton per meter, which is less than 804.47. okay, hence okay, this section is safe. Okay, the section is safe. Okay, clause 8.2.1, to avoid irreversible deformation. Okay, to avoid this irreversible deflections under service loads, MD value should be less than, so this MD value should be less than this much. Okay, so the 1.15 ZE, that is for a cantilever case, I have mentioned it, for a cantilever beams. Okay, you have seen in that code book, clause 8.2.1.2, 1.5 ZE into Fi into 8.2. So where did you get this 8.4 is from here. Okay, 1.5 into 2359.8 into 10 to the power of 3 into 250 divided by this. So ZE value, again you will get it from the steel table itself. Okay, this is from the steel table, SP6.1 into Fi, 250 divided by 1.1 into 10 to the power of 6, it is equal to 804. Here you are substituting Zp, remember that. Here substitution of MD for calculation, it is Zp when you are using beta B. When it is Ze, that you are substituting from the Ze value, okay, while checking 804. So 804 is, okay, greater than MD value of 16 kilonewton per meter. That is the case now. And the value of mu, okay, the value of mu is also 562. So this condition is also same. So 562, it is greater than 562. Okay, 562. Okay, so MD is greater than mu also. Remember that these conditions have been satisfied. So m with respect to this, it is less than that. Okay, here it should be greater. Only thing here, this symbol is changed. Okay, change this symbol, it should be greater. 80.447 is greater than MD. So this is the case. Now deflection check. Let us consider the cantilever beam has shown in the figure with a load of this much. Okay, so the delta value WL to the power of 4 divided by 8 into EI. So this is the working load, remember that. 30 into 5000 to the power of 4 into 8 into 2 into 10 to the power of 5, I value of the section 64. So only this I value is from the steel table, other things are common, the load and everything. Okay, so 18.06, and which is less than this span by 150, 5000 by 150, 33.33, so it is less than that. So this condition, table number 6, IS 800 live load cantilever brittle cladding, means there is no cracks formed. Okay, so this is also safe. Now check for web buckling, because B1 value is given, check for web buckling. Area of the cross section of the web, B1 plus N1 into TW. B1 is given, stiff bearing length is 100 mm, T1 is 550 divided by 2, that is nothing but the 550 is the total depth of the section divided by the 2, that is equal to 275 mm. So An is 100 plus 275 into 9.2, which is equal to 4200 mm². Effective length of the web, clause 8.7.1.5, KL equal to 0.7L, flange is restrained. So if the flange is restrained, remember that. And so there is two things, wrapping thing as well as the another one is the torsional thing. So both are restrained, then KL equal to 0.7 DL. Take that assumption, okay, clause 8.7.1.5. So KL equal to 0.7 into D, 0.7 into 470.4, that is the depth, okay. If you get it, it will get equal to 332.8 mm. Now I value, B1 into TW into 12, okay. So that is the value of I, okay. So this formula, you will get it in the code book itself, okay, how to calculate that. So 100 into TW, 11.12 cube divided by 12, it will get it as 11.0707 into 10 to the power of 3 mm to the power of 4. A value, B1 into TW, 100 into 11.2, 1200 mm square. R minimum, square root of I by A, 11.707 into 10 to the power of 3 divided by A value, okay, that is 1220. So this 1220 is nothing from the steel table, okay. Here itself, A value, not from the steel table, here whatever calculate. So it is 3.23. So lambda value, KL by R, 332.8 divided by 3.21, 103. So clause 8.7.31. So now this is an I section. I section belongs to buckling class C. So you have to refer table 9C to get the value of FCD. For lambda 103, the value of FCD is 103.4 megapascal. So you have to interpolate between 100 and 110 to get the value of lambda, okay, to get the value of FCD, which is equal to 103.4 megapascal. So strength of the web in buckling, web against buckling is FCD W equal to AN into FCD. So 4200 AN value into FCD value 103.4 divided by 10 to the power of 3, so that we will get it directly in kilonewton, that is 434.2 kilonewton, which is greater than mu 225. Hence this section is safe under web buckling. So one more condition, it is safe. Now let us check for the web crippling condition. So Fw equal to B1 plus N2 into Tw into Fy divided by gamma m naught. So this is the case, elevation shown in the web crippling at the support. So N2 value you have to find out. The slope, if you remember, slope is 1 in 2.5, which is there in the code book itself. So first thing you have to find out the value of N. So 2.5 plus R1, that is the root radius, plus thickness of the flange. Okay, this is nothing but the thickness of the flange. So that is your value of N2. Remember that N2 value is 2.5, the root radius, okay, at the ends, plus the thickness of the flange. So that is the value of N2, okay. So find out the value of N2 first, 2.5 into 18, so R1 value plus TF 19.3, you will get it as 93.25. And value of FW from clause 8.7.4, okay, B1 plus N2 into TW into FY divided by M0. So B1 into N2 plus TW is nothing but the area. So 100 plus 93.25 N2 value into 9.2 will be the area of the section into 250, the thickness, divided by the gamma, factor of safety. 10 to the power of 3 is divided, so that the value will get it directly in kilonewton, 491.91 kilonewton, which is greater than 255 kilonewton. Hence the section is safe against the bearing. So again, it is safe in crippling, also safe in buckling also. So the section what you have selected is safe in both the condition, hence the section is safe, and the whatever your section you have selected is well and good, and the design steps are ended here itself, okay. So this steps ends the design steps. Now before ending the section, I will just revise. So first thing is to calculate the load, then get the factored load. For this factored load, get the value of MT and MVD, MU and VU, get the value of this, and equate MU equal to MD in the third step to get the value of ZP required, okay. ZP required, take a section which is having higher section modulus, plastic section modulus, okay, ZP which is greater than ZP required, take any section, select a section, I section or any section, write down its properties. Then after writing down its properties, check the conditions, that is, you have taken this MU equal to MD for two conditions, okay, two assumptions you are doing in here. One is VU less than 0.6 D, VD we are doing, and the second case is that we are assuming it as a plastic section and taking the beta value as 1. So beta value we are taking it 1. So let us check whether it is in plastic section or not. For that you have to check, refer table 2 and do those check, that is B by TW and D by TW. So both the checks you are going to do and see whether it is in plastic section or not. After that, if it is there safe, then find out the value of VD okay, VD you have to find out using the clause 8.4. After finding out the VD, check whether it is less than 0.6 VD or not. After finding out if it is safe, then go for the value of MD, write down this formula and find the value of MD. Then check whether this MD is greater than MU, then whatever you have done is safe. Then check for the deflection criteria, okay, that is what you have done till now, okay, and check for permissible one, that is span by 300 for a simply supported, okay, span by 300 for a SSB simply supported, and delta equal to span by 150 for a cantilever case. That are the two cases, okay, cantilever case, okay, cantilever case, that are the two things. Now this, if it is safe, then it is done, okay. Then if there is a buckling and crippling condition, that is if bearing length is given, check for that itself and it should be greater than the value of the VU, okay, both the cases it should be greater than the value of VU, okay. After those things the design will end. If the, it should be safe in all the criteria, we should design for bending moment, then it should be safe in the value of the deflection and shear, buckling, web crippling, all four cases it should be safe if it is given in web buckling conditions are given, that is B1, bearing length is given. So these are the conditions. Now in this step, three problems, whatever I have solved, this condition is satisfied, V less than 0.6 VD. In our next previous session, we are going to solve when this condition is not satisfied, when VU is greater than 0.6 VD, how to solve the problem and how to calculate the value of MD. Let us see in the next coming session. So let me end this session here. So thank you.